Ah, February, the number one month of the year when it comes to love, and the 11th best when it comes to just about everything else. But along with all that snow outside, you might also notice a lot of hearts, from greeting cards to posters to that heart-shaped box of chocolates you sent yourself so you wouldn't feel so lonely on Valentine's Day. But here at the medical school, hearts conjure up a different and, dare I say, more unromantic picture. Why is it the heart and not the brain that's the seat of our emotions in popular culture? To answer this, join me in the exam room. In this new series, we aim to take your simple and everyday medical questions and have them answered by the best and brightest physicians Yale Medical School has to offer. We turn to Dr. John Martin, an acclaimed physician and professor at the University College of London, which is part of the Yale UCL Collaborative, who we Skyped in from his office in London. Hello, Dr. Martin.
Hello, Noah.
So even though we know that our emotions come from our brain rather than our heart, why has our heart always been the symbol of love?
I think it's probably related to love being the most fundamental of our emotions. And when we get emotional change, that is expressed in the heart. When I, as a man, see a beautiful woman, then as part of Darwinian evolution, I have a response. My pupils dilate slightly, and I feel my heart go a little bit faster. And we feel that in our chest, because the heart is a living pump inside our chest, because the only organ inside us that moves. We don't feel our kidneys, we don't feel our pancreas. And I think when you're falling in love, when your loved one comes into the room, you might occasionally feel a bump in your chest, which is an extra beat caused by all the hormones that are going on inside you. So I think it was natural from the beginning of history that one could associate a change, bang, in your heart with love.
Thank you. Well, before we go, since it is also National Heart Health Month, do you have any quick tips to keep our hearts healthy?
Okay, so Valentine's message number one is do not smoke. Then go to your doctor to have your blood pressure and your cholesterol measured. Be slim. Finally, exercise.
I'll get right on that. Thank you for talking to us.
No, great pleasure. Thank you very much.
Well, thank you for joining us in our inaugural episode of The Exam Room. Join us next month where we debunk more medical myths. Until then, for the Yale School of Medicine, I'm Noah Golden. How long do I have to be on this thing for? I should have taken off that suit jacket.